Once upon a time, a professor in the agricultural department at the University of Tokyo, Isabella Uno, had long wanted a puppy. But he didn't want any kind of puppy. He wanted one of those pure Japanese Akita puppies. And back in the day, these kind of dogs were, you know, hard to find. But obviously the professor, you know, didn't stop what he was looking for. Until one day, one of his students found the dog he was looking for and convinced the professor to adopt him. The professor didn't, you know, he didn't resist the cuteness of the dog, so he obviously took him. Hachigo, or Hachi, was the name of the dog. Soon after the professor adopted Hachigo, they became best friends. The professor loved Hachigo so much, he treated him like his own son. Now, as years went by, Hachigo used to see his owner set off to work at the Shibuya train station. He used to go with him and stay there from the morning till the afternoon, every single day. Until one day, May 21st, 1925. Hachigo was normally just sitting there waiting for his beloved owner to come back. But sadly, that never happened. It occurred that the professor had suffered from a cerebral hemorrhage, which caused him to pass away during his work. Now, after that, Hachigo lived for about 10 years. And would you believe me if I told you that during these 10 years, Hachigo used to go to the Shibuya train station every single day and stay there from the morning till the afternoon. After that, a reporter knew about the story and decided to publish it. After he published it, Hachigo wasn't only a hero to the Japanese people, but he was a hero to humanity. He even has his own monument at the Shibuya train station, as you can see here. Now, we all know that dogs are famous for their loyalty, even way before Hachigo's story. But Hachigo reminded the people that these animals, they want nothing from you. These animals have value. They want only love and care and nothing else. Now, after Hachigo's story, the animal abuse rate dropped spontaneously over the years. But unfortunately, never stopped. And a matter of fact, it has increased in the past like 25 years. And it really saddens me. It saddens me that these animals, just like Hachigo, they get abused, hurt, killed, and even dumped and tested on. Now, I'm really sorry, guys. All right. These animals, they should have water, food, and shelter, just like all of us humans, because these animals are living things. And what saddens me the most, that these animals, they don't get abused by a certain person. They get abused by everyone, starting from children teenagers, and adults. According to statistics, in some countries, about 70% of teenagers abuse these animals. You know why? Because they think it's fun, or just they want to show that they are superior to these animals. Unfortunately, some people abuse these animals without even knowing so. Did you know that some of the pet owners think that punishing the animal is the best way to control his behavior? Some of these punishments are very cruel, and they will lead the animal to be aggressive. And guess what happens if the animal is aggressive? The animal will either get put down, get sold, or gets dumped on the street. Some people, they keep their pet even though he's aggressive, and they think that this pet is a living hell, and I quote. But they neglect him. They put the animal in a very bad physical and environmental condition, and that would lead to the death of the animal. The animal will die either of malnutrition or disease. During the unfortunate event of Hurricane Harvey, over 3,000 animals were found and rescued from the street. And that was during the hurricane. And we don't even know how many animals lost their lives out there, and they didn't get the chance to live in this world. Animal abuse should be condemned and eradicated. I believe that the way to stop animal abuse is to educate and create awareness, not only for the animal owners, but everyone, starting from the children all the way to the adults, because everyone abuses animals. We need strict laws that protect the animals' rights. We need a control unit work hand to hand to police officers to implement these laws. Now, you might be wondering, what should I do? What should I do? I want to help animals, but what should I do to help them? Let me give you the simplest thing you can do. You just speak out. These animals, they cannot talk. That's why we exist. We should talk for them. Albert Einstein once said, "The world is a dangerous place. Not of because people who are evil, but of because people who do nothing about it." Thank you very much.